हरे कृष्णा ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। हरे कृष्णा, इन टुडेज पोस्ट ऑफ श्रवणम स्मरणम वी विल कवर वन श्लोक ऑफ कुंती स्तुति विच इज श्रीमद् भागवतम फर्स्ट कैंटो 8th चैप्टर 25th श्लोक।
विपदा संतुता शश्वत तत्र तत्र जगद्गुरो भवतो दर्शनं यत्स्यात् अपुनर्भवदर्शनम्। विपदा संतुता शश्वत तत्र तत्र जगद्गुरो भवतो दर्शनं यत्स्यात् अपुनर्भवदर्शनम्। I wish all those calamities would happen again and again so that we could see you again and again. For seeing you means that we no longer see repeated births and deaths. I wish all those calamities would happen again and again so that we could see you again and again. For seeing you means that we no longer see repeated births and deaths.
Hare Krishna. This is a very unusual prayer and a stuti that comes in the series of shlokas of Kunti Stuti. Kunti Devi is praying to Lord Krishna to stay back with them when Krishna decides to leave Hastinapura to go to Dwarka. So last week we have covered the two shlokas of Kunti Stuti glorifying the Lord. Here Kunti is telling Lord that please give me difficulties over and over again so that they can utilize that to remember Lord. So since it's a very unusual prayer where a devotee is asking Lord, praying for the Lord to give difficulties, it is unusual because majority of the time when we pray to the Lord, we ask the Lord to remove our difficulties, to remove our unhappiness, to give us more and more happiness. So in that context, what is that philosophical point that Kunti Devi is trying to tell us is an important thing to note. The one important thing that we need to understand is even great devotees face difficulties. Kunti Devi was a great devotee, Prahlad Maharaj was a great devotee, Dhruva Maharaj was a great devotee, Bhishma was a great devotee. All of them in their lifetimes have faced a lot of difficulties, but they have used each one and all of those difficult times to remember the Lord more and more. So that's one very important philosophical point that we need to remember. Devotees also do get difficulties, but they utilize them properly to progress further in devotional service. Acharyas have further explained that sometimes devotees go to the extent that they even thank God for giving difficulties, because that's an opportunity for them to wipe out the bad reactions of their karma. Some of the devotees in the past I also prayed to the Lord thanking him for giving only so much of a difficulty, but in fact they actually deserve much more. So whenever there are difficulties, it is better to remember the Lord more and more so that we can progress in our devotional service. And in this context of the shloka, acharyas have repeatedly make us remember that we have to understand that in this material world in which we live is a place of misery. It may look very negative and pessimistic when we make this statement, but Lord Krishna himself in Bhagavad Gita 8th chapter 15th shloka tells us like this: Mam upetya punar janma dukkha layam ashashvitam napnuvanti mahatmanah samsiddhim paramam gataha mam upetya punarjanma dukkhalayam ashashvatam napnuvanti mahatmanah samsiddhim paramam gataha. After returning me, the great souls who are yogis in devotion never return to this temporary world which is full of miseries, because they have attained the highest perfection. They never return to this temporary world which is full of miseries. So Krishna himself is talking about the material world. It's a place which is temporary and it's a place of miseries. So we should not be thinking that we are living very happily and it's all honky-dory. By design itself, material world is a place of misery. So this is what even the scriptures are telling us, that in this form of life, the human form of life, where we have a very developed and evolved levels of consciousness, we have to see janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha doshanu darshanam. The person who sees this as a real problem of life, which is common to everybody, whether he is from America or whether he is from Middle East or whether he is from India, whether he is rich or poor or whatever level of economic status that he has, he has to face these things, janma mrityu jara vyadhi. So these are the ultimate difficulties that will come to anybody. Some people may say that I will not get diseased, I will not get old because my heart is young, my mind is young. But that's a kind of a foolishness, because ultimately everybody has to face death. Somebody may say that he is not afraid of death, but at least when his fellow beings, when his relatives, when his friends die, he has to again suffer. So suffering because of death, suffering because of facing death, suffering because of fear of death, suffering because of anxiety of death is the common problem for everybody. So in this context, and this shloka basically tells us that we cannot run away from difficulties, but we can make use of our difficulties to remember the Lord more and more, so that we can evolve and progress further in our devotional service. And this is the reason why scriptures are always telling us to wake up. Wake up to the understanding that there are tapatrayas in this material world, in this world of miseries. Miseries which are caused by ourselves, miseries which are caused by others, miseries which are caused by the devatas or the controllers of this universe. Nobody can escape this. That's why we need to pray to the Lord and move forward in our devotional service on the way to back to Godhead. And this is the first step in our path of self-realization. And this is what will take us to the abode of the Lord, which is also known as Vaikuntha. Vai means no, Kuntha means anxiety. The place where there is no anxiety is called Vaikuntha. So our ultimate purpose of our life is to escape from janma mrityu jara vyadhi, the repeated cycle of birth and death. So in that context, we should remember this shloka to accept miseries or difficulties as they are and utilize them to remember the Lord more and more. And this is what Kunti Devi is telling us to do, just the way she has requesting, she is requesting the Lord to give her more and more difficulties so that she can easily remember him more and more. And more and more he is there with him, she is confident that she can escape the cycle of birth and death. So we will again repeat this very important shloka of Kunti Stuti, Canto 1, Chapter 8, 25.
विपदः संतुतः शश्वत तत्र तत्र जगद्गुरो भवतो दर्शनं यस्यात् अपुनर्भवदर्शनं.
So by remembering this shloka, we can also know that one practical application of this shloka is, whenever we face any difficulties, whenever we face any hurdles, we can remember this nice shloka. A nice philosophical point that Kunti Devi is telling us, that she is welcoming difficulties and asking Lord to give her difficulties so that she can remember him more and more. So when we face difficulties, if we think about the shloka, naturally we will also remember the Lord and we will be able to understand and face the difficulties with a proper perspective and mindset. So thus, we remember Queen Kunti, Srimati Kunti Devi, who was a great devotee of the Lord, who had all the qualifications to be very happy, because she is successful, she has got very good parentage. Yet, throughout her life, whenever there was a difficulty, she always prayed for the Lord, and Lord always helped her. And in the end, that's reason why she is praying for more and more difficulties. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.